The high-altitude, high-speed 10-foot wind tunnel is utilized for testing aircraft components, missiles, and various high-speed devices in the high subsonic and transonic speed ranges. That is, at velocities up to the speed of sound. This tunnel is of the single closed circuit type. Power for driving the air around the tunnel circuit is supplied by two of these 20,000 horsepower alternating current induction motors. Each motor turns two fan stages in opposite directions. Frequently, in airfoil investigations, a semi-span wing model may protrude into the airflow from the side of the tunnel. The effects of varying aspect ratio and angle of sweepback of a high-speed airfoil are now being investigated. In addition to the mechanical type balances, a six-component electric resistance strain gauge balance may be used. In the tunnel, the strain gauge balance is placed inside a model to be tested, and the unit is attached to a sting-type support. It may be observed from this diagram how such an arrangement minimizes the airflow interference around the test article. Many important facts are obtained by means of a Schlieren optical arrangement for filming the test. By means of this system, light reflected from a parabolic mirror transverses the test section as an approximately parallel wave light beam and is recorded on a film strip for analysis. The engineer studies these pictures to determine the airflow and qualitative pressure distribution around the test article. By this means, a permanent record is maintained, by which test conclusions and results may always be rechecked. The many automatic features of this tunnel, its range of operating densities from 1/5 to 2 atmospheres, and its air temperature from minus 30 degrees to plus 160 degrees Fahrenheit, allows considerable flexibility in operations. This makes possible the control in the laboratory of the extremes in temperature and pressures encountered by aircraft and missiles in full-scale flight. A freon refrigeration system is provided to dissipate heat energy imparted to the tunnel air by the fans and to maintain a desired temperature. This system is also used in cooling the supersonic tunnels. The brine, cooled to minus 40 degrees Fahrenheit, is stored in these four insulated 100,000-gallon tanks. When needed during tunnel operations, the cold brine is mixed with varying quantities of warmer brine, and at the proper temperature, is passed through cooling coils located in the tunnel. There is an urgent need for wind tunnels which will allow refined testing close to the speed of sound. Transonic problems must be answered before high-speed flight becomes a more commonplace reality. Through the transonic range, flight at supersonic velocities will be facilitated by extensive tests in supersonic tunnels. The Air Materiel Command supersonic wind tunnel is a single return, continuous flow tunnel with a square test section 2 feet on each side. The model may be viewed through thick glass plates mounted on both sides of the test section. Air moves through the test section up to 2.5 times the speed of sound, corresponding to 1,900 miles per hour at sea level conditions. The air is driven around the tunnel circuit by this 8-stage axial flow compressor. The 5,000 horsepower alternating current synchronous motor rotates the compressor through a magnetic coupling for speed control. With the development of tunnels in this velocity range, problems of model balance systems increase manyfold. The physicist has come to the aid of the aerodynamicist with an optical system which has aided immensely in solving many problems. Two illustrative examples of the capabilities of the device may be observed. An ordinary candle flame is viewed through the instrument. The upper picture, or Schlieren, makes the density changes around the flame visible. In the lower picture, the distortion of the optical phenomena, the so-called interference fringes, is directly proportional to density changes in the medium. Pressure distribution around turbine profiles may be determined by this means. These pictures illustrate the starting condition of airflow through a turbine lattice. It is obvious that such a device has widespread application in aerodynamics and other scientific fields. As investigations are being pursued in the wind tunnel facilities, data on all phases of a test are gathered. An important phase of report preparation is the reduction of data into usable form, such as curves, graphs, and tables. A special section of computers and mathematicians receive the raw data from the project engineer. With considerable ingenuity, they interpret these data into curves and charts, which typify reports on wind tunnel investigations. At the completion of an investigation, editors, project engineers, and scientists carefully review reports for technical accuracy and validity of conclusions. In the last analysis, it is the experience and ability of these engineers and scientists, the true driving power in any research effort, that sets the pace for technological advances. The final product of the Air Materiel Command wind tunnels, the Air Force Technical Report, is then printed and made available to all agencies, military, civilian, and educational institutions, whose combined endeavor are constantly conquering the outer boundaries of flight.